Hello students. So today I am going to start the new topic, that is nutrition for class 10. And in this topic we will discuss about how the organism, living organism, get their food. So nutrition, as you know, nutrition is the way of taking food. Way of taking food is known as nutrition. So, entire organisms are divided into two categories. First is the autotrophic nutrition, and second category is the heterotrophic nutrition. So, in first autotrophic, come to the autotrophic nutrition. In autotrophic nutrition, all green plants. All green plants and some bacteria, they are autotroph. Autotroph are those organisms which are able to produce their own food. So, definition is organisms which are able to produce their own food. They are known as autotrophs. So, how do they produce their food? So, the process is known as photosynthesis. The process is known as photosynthesis. Student, you all are aware about photosynthesis. Photo means light, and synthesis means to make. Means these organisms, they prepare their own food. They use the light to prepare the food, to synthesis something. So what is photosynthesis? You know that green plants, they have chloroplast. Chloroplast is a double membrane cell organelle. Plants have chloroplast. Chloroplast is a double membrane like cell organelle. Cell organelle which contain chlorophyll, and chlorophyll is the substance which have ability to absorb the sunlight. So that's why they are known as autotrophs. So autotrophs are those organisms which are able to prepare their own food with the help of chlorophyll, sunlight, carbon dioxide, and they prepare their food, that is carbohydrate, glucose, and release the oxygen gas into the atmosphere. So here is the chemical reaction. Through the chemical reaction I am going to discuss about how the green plants prepare their own food. So 6CO2, 6H2O, water they also require. Chlorophyll is the substance which present inside double membrane cell organelle, that is chloroplast, and sunlight is also required for the preparation of food. So carbon dioxide, water, and the product is CH2O, power N. So power N means if we write 6 here, so the number of carbon will be 6 and hydrogen will be 6 to the 12 and oxygen will be 6. So and 6 oxygen molecule go into the.
So now come to the photosynthesis, how they prepare their food. About photosynthesis, you will study in class 11 in detail. Photosynthesis is a very vast topic, and photosynthesis is completed into two steps. One is the light reaction, second one is the dark reaction. Light reaction, in the light reaction, ATP and NADPH2 form, and in the dark reaction, carbohydrate synthesized. It is very complex to discuss here. You will study in higher classes. So now come to the steps. Steps of photosynthesis. If we discuss about the structure of leaf, so cross section of leaf, so student, you will get leaf having, plant having cell wall, and after cell wall, so the first layer is known as epidermis. First layer is known as epidermis, and epidermis, the upper part is also cuticle, and cuticle is project only the leaf and stem, and epidermis, after epidermis that then parenchyma cells are there. Parenchyma cells. So parenchyma cells, they are known as cortex portion. So at the inner side, you will get the vascular bundle, and vascular bundle they have a pericycle, and this portion is known as pericycle, and xylem and phloem, they are present. Xylem and phloem. So there is a hair sac. At the lower end of the leaf, they contain stomata. Lower end of leaf, they contain stomata, and stomata, they are tiny pore-like structure which help in the exchange of gases. They help in the exchange of gases from plant body to the environment. Air sacs and spaces. So you will see that the tiny green structure is present in the chloroplast, and chloroplast they contain chlorophyll. So it is this structure you will study in detail in class 11. So here is the cross section view of leaf. So this portion is known as axial surface. Axial surface. The upper surface of leaf is known as axial surface, and the lower surface of leaf is known as axial surface. So here the upper layer is the cuticle, below the cuticle is the epidermis, then cortex. Cortex, they are composed of parenchyma cells, and then cortex having two type of parenchyma, one is the pericyte, second one is the spongy. So there is a regular cell, so these cells are known as spongy parenchyma, and here is the pericyte. Okay, and vascular bundles are there. Vascular bundle, they contain xylem and phloem.
So xylem and phloem and stomata, it is a stomata which helps in the exchange of gases. So open stomata, which contain the guard cells, and guard cells help in the opening and closing of stomata. So structure is clear. Now come to the step of photosynthesis. In the structure, so we have got the various parts of the leaf, internal part of the leaf. Now how the photosynthesis start and how it converts the light energy change into the chemical energy. So there are three steps given in your book. First is the absorption of light energy. Absorption of light energy. Second step is the conversion of light energy into chemical energy. And spreading of water molecule into hydrogen and oxygen. In photosynthesis, generally we know that plants, they take the carbon dioxide during photosynthesis and release the oxygen gas. But how we get oxygen, from where we get oxygen? So oxygen, the water molecule is split. Split means break down. Water molecules break down and these water molecules change into hydrogen and oxygen gas. So these gas oxygen come out into the atmosphere, and hydrogen, it by the process of reduction means it added to the carbon dioxide. That reduction of carbon dioxide to carbohydrate means, reduction means addition of hydrogen. So that is known as reduction. So second step is conversion of light energy into chemical energy and splitting of water molecule into hydrogen and oxygen. So it means we get the oxygen from water molecule, not from carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide never split. Carbon dioxide added with hydrogen and converted into carbohydrate. So that is the third step. Reduction of carbon dioxide into carbohydrate. So carbohydrate means having carbon, hydrate means water, hydro means water. So it means having carbon plus water. So carbon plus water, it becomes carbohydrate. So earlier it was CO2, and when hydrogen added, then it become carbohydrate. So in this means the class, only three steps are given. So in detail you will study in higher classes, in class 11. So photosynthesis in higher plants, which is a big chapter, is given in the class 11. So we will discuss in later in detail. So again, students, so the first step is the absorption of light energy. Absorption of light energy through chlorophyll. Green plants, they are able to absorb the light energy due to the presence of chlorophyll. If chlorophyll is not present in the plant, then they are not able to absorb the sunlight. So first step is the absorption of light energy by chlorophyll. So that's why there is a big role of chlorophyll in the process of photosynthesis. Second is the conversion of light energy into chemical energy. So conversion of light energy into chemical energy, it is a multi-step process. And then breaking down of water molecule into hydrogen and oxygen. So that hydrogen added with carbon dioxide and become carbohydrate, and oxygen gas it released from the stomata to the environment. That is known as life-giving gas. So now come to the structure of stomata in detail. Stomata on the basis of shape, stomata is divided into various shapes. So in dicot plant, stomata is a bean shaped stomata. So bean shaped stomata
dog.
vulture. They are carnivores.
Carnivores are those animals which eat the flesh of other animals. They are known as carnivores.
Frugivore, fruit-eating animal. And fruit-eating animal, the animal which eat fruit only, they are known as frugivore. And the example is parrot. Second is sanguivore. The organism which suck the blood sucking organism, suck the blood, they are known as sanguivore. Example is leech. Next, insectivore. Insect eating animals, so like insect eating. So like lizards, frog will also come in the insectivore. Next, cannibals are those organisms which eat their animals, like snake when in the adverse condition, when snakes do not get food, then they feed their animals. And next is the coprophagus, the organism in the adverse condition, they eat their fecal matter. So like rabbit. Rabbit in the adverse condition eat their fecal matter. So now next is the saprophytic. Saprophytic are those organisms which depend on the dead and decay matter. So dead and decay matter, example is saprophytic, so like that jackal and eagle. And parasitic, so some organisms they depend on the other organism, other host body, like ticks, jew, lice, hatmal and kidney. Okay, special. So heterotrophic nutrition is clear here. So organisms are categorized into three categories. All multicellular body or complex organisms are categorized into three categories. First is the holothuric, second is the saprophytic, third is the parasitic. So all complex multicellular organisms, they come in the holothuric. So herbivore, omnivore, carnivore, frugivore, sanguivore, insectivore, cannibals and coprophagous. Various other mode of nutrition is there, kinds of organisms are there, but nutritionally harmless. So in the next video we will discuss about the nutrition in the amoeba and nutrition in human beings.